Hi, my name is Patricia Alves, and I'm from Polytechnic of Porto, Portugal. I'm here to present our work on modeling tourist personality and recommend assistance. How does personality influence preferences for tourist attractions? To start, I'll make a brief introduction, followed by the background on personality and recommend assistance and psychology of tourism. Next, I'll present the methodology used for this study, the results and respective analysis, and finally, a discussion of future work. Traveling is an emotional experience, and therefore, personalization is a key factor for the success of recommender systems in tourism. The more information about the tourist is known, better recommendations can be made. Throughout the last two decades, personalization became a main concern for the effectiveness of recommender systems. Therefore, to know personal information about the user is crucial for building a robust profile. The researchers' increased interest in developing more personalized and accurate recommender systems created the need to consider other research areas such as psychology. Psychological aspects such as personality, moods, and emotions are being perceived to influence the variance in user preferences in behavior in recommender systems, and their consideration is evidencing to show better results than by generic approaches. Information like the tourist's demographics, personality traits, social-cultural aspects, habits, and preferences can be critical factors for the system's effectiveness. Many personalized recommendation systems that take into account users' motivations, mood, or personality have been developed. TripCoach, PixMeAway, and Destes Group are examples of personality-based recommender systems. So, what defines someone's personality? As defined by Isaac, personality is the sum total of the actual or potential behavior patterns of the organism as determined by heredity and environment. Each individual has their own behavior patterns, which are considered relatively stable over time across different situations. These patterns were summarized into five universal personality dimensions: openness to experience, consciousness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism, being the five-factor model, or Big Five, recognized as the most widely accepted model to represent them. Personality can be useful in different areas of recommender systems, since it is strongly related to the user's preferences. Users with similar personalities tend to choose similar items or contents. For example, extroverts, who are dependent on warmth and gregariousness, tend to enjoy popular music, and persons who score high on excitement-seeking tend to enjoy rock music. So, how is personality related to preferences for tourist attractions? For example, what tourist attractions are preferred by more extrovert or open to experienced persons? Research on psychology of tourism is growing fast, since it is evidence that psychological aspects are related to the choice of specific destinations. Which ones? Several researchers try to answer their questions, some by proposing tourist typologies based on psychological aspects, others by trying to refine relationships among personality traits and tourist behaviors or preferences. A great variety of tourist typologies can be found in literature. For instance, Cohen was one of the first researchers to propose a tourist typology. Plog is another renowned researcher who studied the psychology of travel and tourism. Gretzel and colleagues proposed 12 travel personalities and found strong correlations between their respective activities. However, and as pointed by several authors, the existing research on tourism behavior is mostly descriptive instead of predictive, which is a limitation that needs to be overcome. That is, what personality dimensions or traits are predictive of the tourist typologies or preferences found in literature? This led researchers to study the relationships between personality traits and tourist preferences. I will briefly show some examples. For instance, Schneider and Vogt found interest in cultural experiences, need for arousal, and need for material resources were predictors of a hard adventure travel, and interest in cultural experiences a competitiveness of soft adventure travel. And Bushisik and colleagues study how extroversion and openness to experience influence the tourist satisfaction with a set of different tourist experiences. Although many studies of psychology of tourists for different sectors can be found, many are about typologies of tourists, which are descriptive of the tourist's behavior and do not predict how that behavior impacts the choice of tourist preferences. Others try to predict how psychological aspects influence tourist behavior or preferences, but most of them only rely on decision-seeking and or extroversion scales, which do not cover all the Big Five dimensions. Few studies try to correlate all Big Five dimensions to tourist behavior or preferences, but none, to the best of our knowledge, correlate the five personality factors to the choice of a wide range of tourist attractions. Our research is also motivated by the evidence that the tourist typologies found in literature do not fully match the tourist preferences for tourist attractions. Since many different combinations of intensity for the personality traits exist, and therefore a single typology may not be enough for a certain tourist, as well as not all the attractions present in a typology may be suitable for that tourist. In order to start overcoming those limitations, we conducted a large study, and still are conducting, to determine the relationship between the Big Five personality dimensions and preferences for a wide range of tourist attractions. First, we studied the terms used for classifying the most significant tourist attractions. Then, an intensive research was conducted to construct a questionnaire to collect as much information as possible about respondents' personality, tourists, and personal preferences, travel motivations, and sociodemography. Using Snowball sample method, questionnaire was disseminated in several waves by email to various mailing lists of academic institutions in the north of Portugal, including professors, scholars, and general employees, which were asked to share the questionnaire with their respective relatives and friends. The questionnaire comprised five sections, which asked about sociodemographic data, personality characteristics, personal preferences and concerns when traveling, travel motivations, and preferences for tourist attractions when going for an ideal vacation destination. For the work here presented, the responses were collected for 4 months, from October 2019 to January 2020, generating a total of 508 viable responses. Using exploratory and confirmatory factor analysis, we extracted categories of tourist attractions and analyzed which personality dimensions were predictors or not of preferences for those tourist attractions. Now I'll present the results obtained and their respective analysis. As can be seen in the graphics, the sample is characterized by a greater percentage of female respondents, being most of the respondents between 18 and 40 years old. 74% of respondents have a higher education, and the formation area of the majority reflects the academic institutions to which the questionnaire was sent, being more than 50% from exact and engineering sciences, and 26% from social sciences and humanities. As for traveling data, by far the great majority had already visited other countries in their life, showing the respondents had the experience of interacting with other cultures. Per year, 79% of the respondents traveled 3 times or less, and 23% of the respondents had already lived in other countries. As for the items in the questionnaire represented in tourist attractions, this table shows the 68 proposed items. 3 exploratory factor analyses were performed on those items by using the principal components extraction method with Weremax rotation and with Kaiser normalization. Coefficients below 0.40 were suppressed and factors below reliability were removed. This resulted in 48 final items. The items were aggregated into 11 factors, explaining 68% of the total variance. The reliability for the data scale was very good, which confirmed the items in the scale were all related to the same concepts. Next, we named each factor according to the concepts they represented, as can be seen in the table. Adventure, nature, entertainment and nightlife, sun, water and sand, museums and landscapes, theme and animal parks, cultural heritage, sports and games, gastronomy, boat tours, health and well-being. Next, we conducted a confirmatory factor analysis to create a first-order model to confirm which attractions saturate the preference for those tourist attractions and what correlations exist between the 11 factors. After several adjustments, this is the proposed model for the tourist attractions preference. Finally, the responses to the personality questionnaire were treated and correlated to the extracted factors. Here we can see the average scores for each personality dimension was similar, corresponding to the middle of the respective score range, which means most of the participants responded in average neither agree nor disagree. This tendency is better shown in these graphics, where a clear concentration of results in the average scores of the scale can be seen. A clear majority of participants show moderate values in the extroversion and neuroticism dimensions, but in the agreeableness, consciousness, and openness scores distribution, the graphics show higher kurtosis, where the participants classify themselves more between neither agree nor disagree and agree strongly. This higher concentration above midpoint scores may be reflecting some social desirability bias. Next, we apply structural equation modeling and confirmatory factor analysis to the BFI responses in order to predict preferences for the previously proposed tourist attractions. This resulted in the personality to tourist attractions preference model, and very interesting predictions were found. Individuals with a higher preference for adventure tend to score higher on agreeableness but lower on consciousness. This goes in line with evidences from the literature, where less conscious people tend to enjoy risky activities. Also, spontaneous individuals seem to get along easily with others. A higher preference for nature-related attractions is positively predicted by her algorithms. These individuals tend to be more sympathetic, considerate, and altruistic. This may respond to more concern and attracted to nature individuals. Entertainment and nightlife activities are positively associated to all personality dimensions except consciousness. One can presume almost everyone enjoys some form of entertainment or outings, but once again, there is some risk avoidance, as well as a sense of frugality related to conscious persons that does not seem to combine with futile spending and or unhealthy habits. Activities like going to the beach or a swimming pool are strongly related to more extroverted, open to experience and neurotic individuals. Extroverts may appreciate the opportunity to be in contact with other people, but both new and known acquaintances at the same time feel comfortable with their body image. Individuals with high openness may enjoy the aesthetic experience that comes with appreciating a beach for its natural beauty, along with the meditative state its surroundings may induce. In turn, neurotics may appreciate these activities for consisting in somewhat predictable vacations, almost a default option in the context of our country, thus reassuring a strong sense of safety and control which is dear to these individuals. Visiting museums and landscape viewing are preferred by more open-to-experience individuals, while extroverted are negatively associated. Sense can be made that enjoying historical artifacts or pursuing intimate experiences commonly brought by absorbing impactful sceneries are activities more akin to individual enjoyment and solitude. The preference for visiting theme and animal parks is positively predicted by persons with higher agreeableness, neuroticism and extroversion. The preference for theme and animal parks is negatively predicted by openness to experience, possibly for its standardized, not so intellectually challenging nature. No significant prediction was found for consciousness. Ecological sites, monuments, and historic cities or villages are also positively thought by agreeable, conscious, and open-to-experience individuals, but negatively by extroverts, who may not find very exciting that sort of activities as they are averse to sedentarism. Sports and games are negatively associated to conscious and open-to-experience individuals, but agreeableness and extroversion are positively related, which can derive from the cooperativeness, energy, and high activity level inherent to these activities. Gastronomy experiences are positively valued by more agreeable and extroverted person, which can explain why well-prestige foods and wine is usually seen as cheerful and high-spirited. No significant relations are found for the other three personality traits. Both tours are preferred by individuals with higher agreeableness and openness to experience, which is similar to an interpretation given for beach and swimming pool activities and landscape viewing. Health and well-being are valued by those with higher agreeableness and extroversion, but with lower openness. No significant association is found to consciousness and neuroticism, which does not mean they do not exist. The results found demonstrate a strong relation between the five personality dimensions and preferences for tourist attractions. That means preferences for specific tourist attractions can be predicted by the tourist personality, meaning they can be used in recommendations for tourism to automatically model the user's preferences. This work brought new insights, successfully and strongly relating all the Big Five personality dimensions to preferences for specific tourist attractions, showing all the extracted tourist attractions factors are relevant and can be predicted by the personality dimensions, constituting, to the best of our knowledge, the first personality tourist attractions preference model in literature to do so. Since this study is part of an ongoing larger study, we believe the model's fit will considerably improve with the increase in size and heterogeneity of the sample. It was also found that due to self-reporting answers in the BFI, some personality dimensions had a higher concentration above midpoint scores, which may reflect some social desirability bias or that the sample should be more diverse. In fact, most of the respondents had a higher education level, which can explain the greater frequency of higher scores in dimensions like openness to experience and consciousness, meaning this study is limited in predicting tourist attractions preferences for individuals with lower education. Almost most respondents are from exact or social sciences, meaning the so-called poor on other fields of education, which can also account for lower variability found in openness to experience, consciousness, and agreeableness, since, for instance, individuals with artistic formation would positively influence openness to experience overall score. Also, we cannot forget the questionnaire was conducted in the Portuguese population, and therefore some relationships found between personality and tourist attractions can be culture-specific. However, our intention is to conduct the same study on different cultures and compare the results. Although personality revealed to be a great predictor of tourist preferences, to focus only on the five personality dimensions and on the more granularity traits and on the correlation between them seems to limit the preferences prediction. For example, a person considered extroverted may not be a risk taker or like adrenaline fuel activities. It would not be very good if a recommended system suggested roller coaster to the tourist. Since the questionnaire allowed to obtain significant data, it will be further analyzed along with the incoming data to determine which of the 30 personality traits can be inferred from the BFI. With the ongoing questionnaire, we also intend to study how personality influences tourist travels, motivations, and concerns while traveling. Finally, it is quite evident that personality is not the only responsible for tourist preferences, but it seems undeniable that personality plays an important role in the kind of tourist attractions one chooses to visit. Thank you, and stay safe.